HeliMed 99 is airborne. On board are paramedics Al and Mikey.
We've been called for an RTC on the A19, literally at the back of the airfield. Don't have any details, just been told that there's an elderly male trapped in a car that's rolled over. It will be quite beneficial to get there as quick as we've gone out. A 30-second transit.
The crash was caught on dash cam. The hatchback drifts across the road, forcing the van to swerve before overturning. It's not long before the team spot the wreckage from 500 feet up.
And there it is on its roof.
I reckon that'll be it.
Corner of that field then.
Passed over the big pylon. There's a car to the right, Al, as you see as well. There might be a patient over there.
Okay. Clear down.
They're landing close to the van and a smashed car. The paramedics are prepared for serious casualties. HeliMed 99 has raced just a short distance from its base at RAF Topcliff to the scene of a head-on crash. The paramedics are expecting serious injuries.
Look at the high vis that's been in this vehicle.
Yep.
That has landed as that. He's managed to get out. He's complaining of quite severe neck pain. He doesn't want to move it. He feels like he couldn't feel it when we first got here. Down there, we've got an elderly male who's been involved in the accident as well.
Al must assess the elderly car driver. Wreckage from the crash is strewn across the road.
Do you have any regular heartbeat normally, sir?
The 58-year-old van driver is lucky to be alive. He crawled out through a window, and Mikey wants to rule out serious injuries.
What's your name, sorry?
Terry Lockie.
Terry. Okay, Terry. Thank you.
I can't turn.
All right, no, that's fine.
If I try and move my head...
Don't do it, then.
Feels really stiff.
Right, around the side or around the back?
Round the side. Actually, it's the back that's holding it.
Okay.
Van driver Terry is shocked and in pain.
Do you remember what happened?
I noticed the car on the other side of the road starting to veer on my side of the road.
Yeah.
So I tried to swerve left, hit me, and I was upside down.
Do you know how many times you rolled, or was it just once?
I don't know.
I think it was once. I got it kind of airborne.
Witnesses saw the crash happen.
He just clipped it and it just sent it up in the air, and it was just literally flying past me onto its roof. Looking at the guy crawling out the van, you know, you wonder to yourself, is he doing that because he's all right, or is he doing it and he doesn't realise how bad the injury is? He's just, it's actually quite scary to see something like that and then see somebody come out of that wreck.
The elderly car driver narrowly missed an articulated lorry travelling in the opposite direction. Al's now checked him over.
This chap seems okay. He's not complaining of any pain. He's mobilised.
Low cloud, wind and rain are making for a miserable end of the day in North Yorkshire.
Tail's coming left.
And they're going to make HeliMed 98's emergency mission even harder.
If the weather's not very bright and anybody's not happy, speak up and we'll come on.
No worries.
The tailwind is speeding them to their patient.
155 knots across the ground is not too bad, is it?
No, it's shifty,
anyway. 10 minutes already to get there.
That's 180 miles per hour, 3 miles a minute.
As long as they don't get down on the other side.
Yeah.
And their speed is helping them outrun the bad weather. The clouds are clearing just in time.
The sun's poking through almost.
On the small field this side, the little hillock in the middle of it. Looks like it's better. You're going to get to
S98, as you'll see.
They're touching down next to the main road from York to the seaside town of Whitby.
You hit the car. It's like bullseye the windscreen of the car.
The scooter rider's body did this to the BMW's windscreen and roof.
Hi, I'm Simon.
On his back, just so that we can...
Yeah, of course you can.
Open fracture of the leg, there's another leg. We can't really see it properly. So
okay, we've got enough hands on to get...
Loads of hands.
So just hand on his hip and side. What's his name?
Paul.
So is everybody ready? And so what we're going to do, we're going to go ready, steady, roll, okay?
Yeah.
You understand as well, Paul? Just go with it. Ready, steady, and roll.
Well done, Paul.
47-year-old Paul Catania is in the care of several off-duty paramedics who were passing by chance.
What's he had energy-wise now?
Nothing.
That's it, yeah?
You've literally only been here like 5 minutes.
Yeah, no, that's fine, yeah, that's fine.
His leg is badly broken, so is his foot.
Lovely.
There's a real risk he may lose it.
So, probably could use some ketamine. We'll get that leg out to length.
They need to straighten his leg to restore the blood flow, quickly.
Can we just get a blanket from the ambulance, please? Thank you.
A local GP also helped after the accident.
The lady in the car is feeling very faint, blood pressure's dropped, but the gentleman here is obviously the one who's most seriously injured. We just got a line in really just for IV access later on until new experts arrived.
Paul's going to be given ketamine so he can stand the pain of his leg being straightened.
I'm going to give you some drugs that are going to mess with your head, and all this will seem like a distant dream at some stage in the next future, OK?
Straightening his shattered thigh bone should reduce his pain and reduce the chance of lethal internal bleeding.
Paul? Is he still breathing?
Yeah.
It's a fine balance between giving him enough that he doesn't remember and a general anaesthetic.
Ready, steady.
Excellent, that's fine. Where we are?
So, okay, so... Yes, you can have some TXA.
And pelvis.
I'm happy with his pelvis.
On the A19 north of York, the team have joined a desperate fight to free the trapped driver of a vintage Jag.
Aaron, how's that painkiller? Is it working?
Young motorist Aaron's life is on the line.
How's his pulse? Is it still 140-ish?
His rapid heart rate is alarming.
Any indication of blood?
No, I don't think so. He's got a radial. It's GCS-15.
Firefighters are slowly cutting the Jag apart, but it's agonisingly slow going.
It's such a big, heavy, well-built car. So consequently, it's going to take quite a bit of dismantling when it's been subjected to this amount of force to kind of pull apart the bits we need to get the patient out.
What I'm trying to do is make room in the vehicle so we can move the casualty's legs away from where the impact zone is. At this moment, it's just a slow step-by-step process, taking small parts of the vehicle away so we can have more room and see what we're doing as we're progressing on with the extrication.
At least Al can now see some of Aaron's injuries.
I think it's an open fracture. I can't tell whether it's bone or jeans, but it's going to be open, isn't it? For sure. There's blood coming out of his shoe on the other side as well, so he's going to have at least one open fracture, isn't he?
Aaron's injuries are potentially life-threatening, and there's still no knowing how much blood he's lost.
Right, we've got that out.
Firefighters are now using hydraulic rams to force the bodywork apart. Al's trying to reduce blood loss.
Is that left foot going to come out, or am I taking his left foot off?
We'll know very soon.
Dr. Brian may soon be forced to act.
Might have to cut it off.
Brian and colleague Dr. Dave Driver are discussing an operation that is tricky, even in an operating theatre.
His leg bends there and then goes that way under all that lot.
Right, let's leave that there. Yeah. Obviously, I'll need your advice whether or not this foot comes off. But we'll just give him another few minutes to this bit to see what happens, OK?
Yeah. We're over an hour in now. Yeah, if there's something serious going on, he'd be going downhill by now. So it probably is just legs.
This is the last hope for Aaron's trapped leg. The fire service has changed tactics and their rams are making progress, but it's still slow going.
Well, unfortunately, this extrication has gone on longer than expected, and it now looks as though the medics are going to have to really do something quite dramatic to free this casualty from his vehicle. To enable us to do that, we've got the other doctor coming on the second aircraft, so the two doctors, along with the paramedics, can do the best they can for this injury.
A makeshift operating table has been prepared, but they must carry out the amputation in the crushed footwell of the wrecked car. Then, there's a breakthrough.
It's going to come out of that now. I think it's going to come out now. Just get the board in next to him, we'll just transfer him across onto the board.
After almost 3 hours, Aaron is free.
And head towards the ambulance. So spin him round.
At last, the team can properly examine their patient. For Dr. Brian, it's a moment of intense relief.